Hi everyone, my name is Danish Aziz bin Sufyan. I am currently taking foundation in business. Today, me and my group are going to do an assignment about risk management plan. We as a team are going to show you the risk management plan when you are in the kitchen. There are about 6 steps to follow in the risk management plan process. The first one will be, we have to identify the potential losses. I will show you in the next video.
In this video, I am cooking dinner for my family and I touched the hot wok accidentally. So, in this situation, my hand is the potential loss because it can cause injury. The second step is evaluate the potential losses. In this situation, a burnt hand can lead to serious medical problems if not treated properly immediately. This is because they expose the body to bacteria. Burn can also result in serious infections. For the third step, which is select a risk management technique. As you can see in this video, I am cooking and I want to touch the hot wok. But this time I am using the clean cloth, or you can use mittens or cooking glove. By this you can prevent hand injuries or prevent the potential risk.
Hello, Madam Amalina. My name is Azim Shahid. So now I'm going to be explaining to you my group's first risk management method for the first risk that we managed to identify in the kitchen, which is here, the pot or pan, which can be very hot if you turn on the fire for a very long time. So as you can see, now it's not hot obviously, but if you somehow left it for a pretty long while, it can get very hot. So the method that we came up with was this thing called a mitten. As you can see, if you wear it, you can lift the pan without risking burning your hand. Ta-da! Let me just shut the fire. Yeah, so thank you. As you can see, if you wear a mitten, you will not risk burning your hand, and that can be very good because your hand is obviously very important to do daily activities.
This method is also very good because you can buy your mittens in an assortment of colors. As you can see, my favorite one is this. It comes in blue, green and red. And also, this is my mother's favorite mitten. We bought it in Australia. Then we have these small mittens. So you won't risk burning your hands off if you have these things. You can also wear mittens if you have a spoon or spoodle in the pot or pan, and you can use the mitten to lift it up. You know, because some mittens and some spoons or spoodles are made of steel and they absorb heat. So if you are wearing one, you will not risk burning your hand also. Thank you.
Hello, assalamualaikum. My name is Shakir Zafari Shah, Ben Azman Shah, and my ID number is 01202007193. So the first step, we identify that while cutting, we always have any case of injuries. So we identify that most of the people are lack of cutting the things that they want to cook. So as I said just now, this can cause a lot of damage to people, to ourselves too. Like if we don't follow the steps or rules while cutting, or while using a sharp things in the kitchen. So in this case, it might look simple actually, but we are talking about our hands while we're doing some sharp things or anything It's because our hands is very, very sensitive. So this is how it looks like if we're not cutting it properly in the kitchen. So I will show you the steps and the guide.
So here I'm back. So firstly, like, if we want to cut anything before we go, we make sure that our table is stable.
And while you're cutting, you need to use a proper knife in any things that you cut. So the next part is you need to hold the knife properly and you never cut towards yourself or you stab yourself while cutting it. So lastly, that we also gonna make sure that our hand is clean and not wet, so we not getting any slippery while we're cutting any short things. And using a glove is highly recommended and much safer.
So that is all for me. So we will continue by my friend Daniel. So he's gonna show you the next step.
Hi, my name is Muhammad Daniel Masifu. My ID number is 012-0200-72730. So I'm gonna show you the fourth step, which is to select a wrist management technique during cutting. So the step is wearing a glove because it can protect you from getting injuries. So actually, this is not the gloves that was meant to use in this video, because this glove is not cut resistant. The actual glove is a cut resistant glove, which is made out of stainless steel, but I didn't have the chance to buy it due to the pandemic. So the glove can protect for getting cut or laceration because it is made out of stainless steel, but it cannot eliminate the probability of you getting a cut, but it can reduce the injury or the risk. So it's proven very efficient because many chefs and workers who has cutting tools use it and reduce the injury by 60%. So in order for us to reduce the injury while cutting, is to wear a stain cutting glove so that no injuries or knife accidents can happen, and it can be treated minorly.